Zaga, Zao, oh na 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 na, Gorilla Black, where you from?
I'm strictly business, just like EPMD.
Okay, another question. This is something that I know a lot of people in the public don't really know, but you came up under the Ice-T in the beginning of your career.
Yeah, man, Ice-T.
Elaborate, because a lot of people don't know. They think you're overnight success.
A lot of people don't know, you know what I mean? Ice-T was really one of the first instrumental people that really I dealt with. You know, I remember I was around like 14, 15, and Ice used to sit down and just really school us on being clever and having punchlines and making, you know, we used to record up at the crack house up at his house, you know what I mean? So, I mean, dude was so instrumental in helping me, and he always said, you know, like, doing this and just keep working at it, keep perfecting your shit, and just keep staying up on it and keep going at it. And I mean, you know, just going through the Van Warped Tour, different things like that, open up for Ice. And, you know what I mean? Like you said, a lot of people really don't know my history. A lot of people just think that it was out of anywhere, you know, and oh, they just found them a big old black dude that looked, you know, a lot of people really think that. So a lot of people don't know that I'm really hood connected and hood affiliated. So, you know what I mean? Watch your step, kid. You dig what I'm saying? So, that's all I can say to that fact, brother. You know what I mean? I feel like, you know, I'm a benevolent king. You know what I mean? I know I'm a king. You know what I mean?
So, you guys still communicate to this day?
Man, yeah, come on, man. Ice is like extended family. You know what I mean? Shouts out to everybody from Burn Unit. That's all, you know. That's my boys. You know, they doing their thing. My boy, Fetty DeMarco, definitely doing his thing. Gotta check this kid out, too, man. He's crazy. Crazy, man. Shouts out to all of them, man. You know what I mean? And, you know, that's his family, man. That's gonna be family. And they were the first cats that were there. Actually, put me in the studio. Ice was the first dude that put me behind an AKG in a booth. So, for all of y'all who don't know about that, the king of gangster rap started this shit. You know who that is. Ice, none other. Nobody else was talking no street shit. I don't give a fuck with who he was here on the West or here in the East. He was the first one to come 6 in the morning. Started reality rap. Listen to some of the NWA tapes. They'll tell you better yet that they just took that and just amped it and revamped it and made it even better. So, you know what I mean? Definitely, I came under one of the legends.
Made me think of another question. How do you feel about a lot of people out here that say that you gotta come out the NWA tree? You know what I'm saying? Because I know your first album that you came out with, it was successful. And you didn't have any great production. You didn't have any, like...
You know what, man? It's just like this. Man, can't nobody say shit about Gorilla. Gorilla stood on his own too. I didn't come in under Dre, I didn't come in under Snoop, I didn't come in under Quick, I didn't come under Mac-10, and I'm not knocking any of these people. I'm saying that I got my own deal. I went and shot my videos. I went out and sold my 400,000 units. My goddamn self. I went out there and stayed on the road and did 175 promo days. My goddamn self. I didn't ask for nobody's help. If they offered it to me, it was, you know, I definitely shouts out Fred Wreck, Nate Dogg, definitely. They did their thing on my project. But so far as, you know, me leaning up on anybody, I leaned on nobody. I leaned on myself. I stood on my own too. I held my nuts and I banged the city. Dollar figure.
Yeah. All right. Any last thoughts? Anything else you want to
add? Man, like I say, man, I want y'all to look for this project, man. It's coming, man. Hot Dollar. I want y'all to also look out for my new projects. It's coming. But for my new mixtape, it's by DJ Will and Rampage. Real niggas say real shit. Look for the next mixtape coming to you. You know what I mean? I hate it when you love it. I hate it. I love it when you hate me, Volume 1. Better yet, you know, yeah, nigga, my tongue twisted. I'm smoking. So you already know, but definitely, man, I want to give shouts out to everybody in Dollar Figure. You dig what I'm saying? Shouts out to everybody who had anything to do with this. Shouts out to my boy as well, Nick Bean. He's been doing it for a minute. A lot of cats don't understand that. Dude is officially out here in the streets. A lot of you DJs, y'all hiding. A lot of y'all DJs, y'all up on, you know, y'all sit up in your little computer booths and make mixtapes and stand back. But Nick Bean is really,
I'm really in the streets.
Really in the streets. Nick Bean's come to my salons when there's nothing but gangsters around, smoking weed, drinking liquor with pistols. You know what I'm saying? Out here. So I just definitely want to give him that shout out, man. Nick Bean, definitely love you for doing your thing, man, and keeping it 100, man. West Coast, Dollar Figure.
What do you suggest to all the people out there trying to get in the game?
Man, I just, man, tell you one thing, man. If God had a meant this, man. It's gonna happen for you. The path that God laid for you, it's gonna come to fruition if that's what God had planned for you to do. And if it's this music game, He's gonna let you in the door, and He's gonna open up the door for you to go through it. Whether you succeed or whether it's, you know, failure or whatever, there's no real failure, I feel, in this game, because you just gotta look at how many people who are really trying to do it, and how blessed if you are in a situation or have been in a situation to actually participate in one of the, you know, most, I think, you know, prominent genres that ever came about in music history. So I feel proud that I've been able to be a part of hip-hop history. And definitely, man, I just want to, you know, keep moving and continue to grow, man. And growth is going to continue to move with me. So, you know what I mean? For everybody out there who's definitely trying to do their thing, I hope and pray that they stay prayed up, man. You know what I mean? They stay humble, man. Easy to work with, man. And stay hungry, man. And that's just it, man. Period, point blank.
All right.
I had to hit your cell phone. I left you a message, it went like this: I love you. I guess it's my luck. I goes to the magic.